Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. We are discussing a straight line and this is a video lecture number 11. I hope you have already watched part 1 to part 10 before watching this part 11. In this lecture, we are going to discuss some questions, problems which we have learned, the concept of which we have learned in previous lecture. So let us start some questions which we are going to discuss today, and the questions on the basis of some concept. So starting from question number 14, 13 even, 13 is also there. So starting from question number 13, 13 question is there, and find the equation of right bisector. This question is, find the equation of right bisector. Right bisector, we are discussing a straight line, and this is the topic. Find the equation of right bisector, of the line segment, joining the points, points minus 1, 3, points 3, 4 and minus 1, 2. So we have to find the equation of right bisector joining these two points, say if this is a line, say, and that we have to find another line which is a right bisector of this line. So we can choose a line of which is, say this is a line, right, and we have to find another line which is a bisector of this one. Bisector means, right bisector means perpendicular division. So it will be, must be perpendicular. And bisector means those which will divide the line segment. Line segment, it is a line segment, not line. So let us write the line segment there. So it is a, not a line but line segment, so it must have a fixed end, right now? So that will be like this. So it will be a line, and this line has end points A and B. This one is a point that is 3 comma 4 and that is minus 1 comma 2. These are the points, and here this must bisect at this point M. So this portion and this portion must be same. We have to find the equation of line CD. CD, right? My equation of line CD, that is a perpendicular to it. So it is a right bisector. Right bisector, bisector means dividing two equal parts. So for solution, if we write, let M be the midpoint of line segment. AB, and therefore what will happen? The coordinate of M is, what? 3 plus minus 1 divided by 2, x1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1 plus y2 by 2, right now? So x1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1, that is 4 plus 2 by 2. That is what? 3 minus 1, 2 by 2 is 1, and 4 plus 2, 6 by 2 is 3. So this is the point, coordinate of M is 1 and 3. Now we can find the slope of AB. Slope of AB is given by here, slope of AB, slope of line AB is given by slope M1, say, that is y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So that is minus 2 upon minus 4, which is 1 by 2. Now slope of line CD, if slope of line CD, is M2 and M1 is, AB is perpendicular to CD, therefore M1, M2 must be equal to minus 1. And therefore, we can write here, M1 is 1 by 2 into M2 is equal to minus 1. This employee M2 is equal to minus 2. So slope of CD line is minus 2, and CD is passes through M. Since CD is passes through M, CD is passes through M, that is coordinate M, of coordinate of M is 1 comma 3, right? Now this is what 1 comma 3, and hence equation of, and therefore equation of CD is, equation of line CD, that is perpendicular bisector of line segment, perpendicular bisector of AB, is y minus y1, that is 3, slope, that is minus 2, x minus x1. So that will be y minus 3 is equal to minus 2x plus 2. And now the things will be 2x plus y, this 2x will come this side, and 3 will come that side, it will be plus 5 is equal to 5, which is the required equation of line, which is the required equation of line. Right? So this is the question number 12. Now let us discuss question number 13. And question number 13 is there, but now let us discuss question number 14. Find the coordinate of foot of perpendicular. Find the coordinate of foot of perpendicular. Coordinate of foot of perpendicular from point minus 1 comma 3 to the line 3x minus 4y minus 16 is equal to g. So the coordinate of foot of perpendicular drawn from this to line this. So here is a question, and this is a line. Line is given. So line is given here like this. This is a line. Okay. And the foot of perpendicular drawn from this point is, say M. This is a foot of perpendicular. Drawn from where? Drawn from minus 1 to 3. This is a point P. And this one is N. Now this line is 3x minus 4y minus 16 is equal to 0. This is the line. 3x, this line is 3x. This line is 3x minus 4y minus 16 is equal to 0. So what will be the slope of PL? So slope of line, therefore we can write solutions like slope of line, or any line perpendicular to this, can be written as what we have learned. So why not we can use it? So any line perpendicular to 3x minus 4y minus 16 is equal to 0 is what? Change the coefficient and sign also, ax plus by, then what is that, dx minus ay, line perpendicular. So that can be 4x plus 3y plus k is equal to 0. Change the coefficients and sign with a. So this will be a equation. Since it passes through minus 1, 3, so we can write it. Since it passes through minus 1, 3, and hence it will satisfy the equation. So 4x plus 3y plus k is equal to 0, and passes through what? Minus 1, 3. So we can put here, this employee 4 into minus 1 plus 3 into 3 plus k is equal to 0, right? So that will be 9 minus 4 is 5, and therefore k plus 5 is equal to 0, and hence k is equal to minus 5. So putting in 1, therefore equation of line will be equation of line perpendicular to 3x minus 4y minus 16 is equal to 0 is, what is that? 4x plus 3y minus 5 is equal to 0. So this is the line. Now solving these two, you will get the point of intersection, and that will be put up perpendicular. Now solving these two equations, we get what? How to solve? We can find here, multiply this 3x from here. I can write 4y is equal to 4y is equal to 3x minus 16 from first, and therefore y is equal to, what is y? Therefore y is equal to 3x minus 16 upon 4. This is third equation, say, and this one is second, and this one is first. So from first I have written this, putting in the value of y in second, we get what will happen? 4 times of x, 4x plus 3 times of y. Y is nothing else but 3x minus 16 upon 4 minus 5 is equal to 0. So that will be, this employee, what will happen this? That will be 16x plus 9x minus 16, 3 is 48, divided by 4, and that 4 will multiply this side also. So 4, 5 is 20, whole divided by 4, that will multiply towards 0 and it will be 0. So now this will be a 25x is equal to 68, and x is equal to 68 upon 25. Now from third, y is equal to 3x minus 16 by 4, that is 3 times of 68 by 25 minus 16, whole divided by 4, that is 8, 3 is, what is that? 8, 3 is 24, 2, 6, 3 is 18, 2, 20 minus 400 divided by 4, and that will be 196 divided by 4. 196 minus divided by 4, 4, 4 plus 16, this is 49. So the foot of perpendicular is what? 68 by 25 comma minus 49. That will be answer of this question. Now let us solve question number 15, and it is given that the perpendicular from origin to the line y is equal to mx plus c meets it at the point minus 1 comma 2. Find the value of m and c. Right now? So, perpendicular drawn from this, we can have equations like here, if this is a line, say, right now? So, if this is a line, say, this is x-axis, this is x dash, there is y and y dash, right now? So y dash, that will be the line, okay? Now line is y is equal to mx plus c, so we can write here y is equal to mx plus c. Line is y is equal to mx plus c, so this is a line, you know, this is a line, say y is equal to mx plus c. And foot of perpendicular drawn from here, origin to this line, is like this, right now? So perpendicular drawn from origin to the line, that is like this, okay? So here, that will be foot of perpendicular drawn from origin to the line will be like this. This is a foot of perpendicular drawn from origin to the line. So that is a point which is this M, say this point is called M. If it is M, then coordinate of M is minus 1 comma 2. X is minus 1, y is 2. And this line equation is y is equal to mx plus c. Now, since minus 1, 2 lies on this line, this will satisfy. And this is origin, so coordinate of this is 0, 0. So first thing, since minus 1 and 2 for solution, we can write, since minus 1, 2 lies on line, y is equal to mx plus c, hence satisfy the equation. Hence, it will satisfy, that is 2 is equal to minus m plus c. Also, slope of OM is equal to, what is slope of OM? Slope of OM is, what is that? Minus 1 and 2. So, y2 minus y1, 2 minus 0 upon minus 1 minus 0, that is minus 2, right now? Slope of, and since this line is perpendicular to, and slope of line, and slope of given line, slope of line perpendicular to OM is M, and therefore M1, M2 is equal to minus 1, product of slope is minus 1, that is minus 2 into M is equal to minus 1, so minus minus cancel, and M is equal to 1 by 2. Now from first, what is the equation? That 2 is equal to minus m plus c. 2 is equal to minus m plus c. So c is equal to, therefore c is equal to 2 plus m, that is 2 plus half, and 2 plus half is 5 by 2. So value of m is half and value of c is 5 by 2. That will be answer. So c is this one, one value is this one, that is half. And then another value is this, that will be the answer. There are two answers. So I hope you got it. Okay. Now the next question that I would like to take on, that is question number 16. And it is given that if P and Q are the length of perpendiculars, if P and Q are the length of perpendiculars, From origin to the lines, x cos theta minus y sin theta is equal to k cos 2 theta, and x sec theta plus y cosec theta is equal to k, respectively. Prove that p square plus 4q square is equal to k square, right? This is what. So solution of this question can be, length of perpendicular, we know length of perpendicular from origin to the line is x plus by plus c is equal to 0, is c divided by under root a square plus b square, isn't it? So using this concept, and therefore length of perpendicular from origin to the line, which line? First line is x cos theta minus y sin theta is equal to k cos 2 theta, right now? So that will be constant, k cos 2 theta. That will be p is the length of perpendicular line x cos theta. X cos theta minus y sin theta. X cos theta minus y sin theta is equal to k cos 2 theta is k cos 2 theta is p, and p is k cos 2 theta divided by coefficient of a square plus b square. A is nothing else but under root cos theta whole square plus sin theta whole square, isn't it? Cos square theta plus sin square theta is 1. So that will be nothing else but 1, right now? So cos square theta, this will be cos square theta plus sin square theta is 1. So that will be k cos 2 theta. That is equation 1. Now also the length of perpendicular, also the length of perpendicular, length of perpendicular from origin to the line, origin to the line, which line? Next line is x sec theta plus y cosec theta is equal to k. X sec theta plus y cosec theta is equal to k is given by q is equal to what? That is k upon under root sec square theta plus cosec square theta, isn't it? A square plus b square. That we have to calculate, right? So we can do this because here the value is like this, right now. So that will be a cos theta plus b sin theta. So that can be written as k upon, this is sin square theta plus cos square theta. If you write this a cos square theta, this will be 1 by sin square theta, and that will be under root. Then sin square theta plus cos square theta will be 1, but in denominator there will be sin theta cos theta, right? Now sin square theta cos square theta, which will be after removing from a square root, it will be sin theta cos theta. So that will be k sin theta cos theta divided by 1. Inside there will be sin square theta plus cos square theta, that will be 1. So if you multiply by 2 both the sides, then what will happen? 2q is equal to k 2 sin theta cos theta. 2 sin theta cos theta is sin 2 theta. So 2q is equal to here, 2q is equal to k sin 2 theta. This is second one. And the first one was p is equal to, what was that? P is equal to k cos 2 theta. Now this was the first. So squaring and adding, on squaring and adding, squaring and adding, we have p square plus 2q whole square is equal to k square cos square 2 theta plus k square sin square 2 theta, isn't it? So that will be p square plus 4q square is equal to k square, and inside this will be cos square 2 theta plus sin square 2 theta, and that is 1. So there will be k square, which is the proof. I hope you got it, right man? So this is very, very important one. This question is very important one, and you need to know. You just practice them again and again. This has been asked earlier in competitive examination, and still it is liable to ask in competitive examination. So result is very important, and the way in which we have solved it, that is also very important. So try to learn them. And now I would like to solve another question, that is question number 17. And what is that? Let us see question number 17. And 17 is, in a triangle ABC, with vertices A 2, 3, B 4 minus 1 and C 1 comma 2. Find the equation of length of altitude find the equation of length of altitude from vertex A, right? So there is a triangle, and triangle is here. I can write this triangle is here, and if I can do it, ABC. We can rename this. This is B, and coordinate of B is 4, -1. This is C. Coordinate of C is 1, 2, and this one is vertex A, that is 2, 3. Altitude means what? Altitude means this those which will perpendicular to the opposite vertex, that is called altitude. So this is an altitude, right now? So AD is an altitude. We have to find the equation of altitude AD. So we can find slope of BC. Slope of BC is BC. M1 is equal to, what is that? So y2 - y1, that is y2 - -1, that is 2 + 1, upon 1 - 4, that is 3 upon -3 is equal to -1. Slope of, since AD is perpendicular, let slope of AD is M2. And since AD is perpendicular to BC, therefore M1, M2 must be equal to -1. And here M1 is -1 and M2 is there, and that is equal to -1. So M2 is equal to, what will come? 1. So slope of AD is 1. And now equation of AD has to be right here. So A is passes through 2, 3. And therefore equation of AD can be written in 1-point form. AD is y1 is 3, is equal to slope of this line, that is 1, x - x1, that is 2. So y is equal to x + 1, because this is -2 and 3 will come this side, it will be positive. This is the equation of altitude. Is the equation of AD, and that will be the answer that you have to calculate. So that is the answer. I hope you got it. Now the next question is question number 18. And question number 18 is given, if P is the length of perpendicular from origin to the line whose intercepts on axes are A and B, then so that, what is that? So that 1/P² is equal to 1/A² + 1/B². Now we can find this equation as A. See, this one is a line, right? And if I can write like this, this is x-axis, isn't it? And this is y-axis. So this is y, this is x, right? X-axis. And line intercept here, line intercept, this is a line. Say this is a line, okay? So that will be line, and length of perpendicular from origin to the line is given here. Length of perpendicular from origin to the line is given, that is P. This is called P, right now? So this is a P. Length of perpendicular from origin to the line is P. So P is here, that is a length of perpendicular. Now equation of line, since x intercept is A and y intercept is B, therefore equation of line is इक्वेशन ऑफ लाइन इज एक्स बाई ए प्लस वाई बाई बी इज इक्वल टू वन. दिस इज एंड सिंस पी इज द लेंथ ऑफ परपेंडिकुलर फ्रॉम ओरिजिन टू द लाइन एंड देयर फोर लेंथ ऑफ परपेंडिकुलर फ्रॉम ओरिजिन दैट इज जीरो जीरो टू द लाइन एक्स बाई ए प्लस वाई बाई बी इज इक्वल टू वन इज पी एंड देयर फोर लेंथ ऑफ परपेंडिकुलर फ्रॉम ओरिजिन टू द लाइन इज डिस्क्राइब एज कॉन्स्टेंट अपॉन. सो दिस इज माइनस वन अपॉन कोफिशियंट ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर दैट इज वन बाई ए स्क्वायर प्लस कोफिशियंट ऑफ वाई होल स्क्वायर दैट इज बी स्क्वायर. So what will happen if you took this, because this will come here, x plus y minus 1 is equal to 0 can be also written. So c is equal to minus 1. C is equal to nothing else but minus 1. So by taking modulus sign, this will be positive, right? Now? So that will be 1 upon under root 1 by a square plus 1 by b square. Now squaring this both, on squaring it will be p is equal to or even we can write it like later we will square it because it will be this will come this side and that will be p will be divide. So that will be under root 1 by a square plus 1 by b square is equal to nothing else but 1 by p. So on squaring now you can square it. Squaring, what will happen? Root will be removed, 1 by b square, and there will be 1 by b square. That you have to prove. So, this is the proof of this. I hope you got it right now. Isn't it? So, that is the very good chapter, and good questions are there. So, you must practice this again and again. And definitely, if you practice this 2 times or 3 times, concept will be also clear, as well as you will be able to think about the questions. If any new questions will come, you will be able to solve it. Thank you. Thank you very much. God bless.